Hey guys, in today's video I'm going to show you an amazing way to work with data using ChatGPT, all without writing a single line of code. It's like being a director, guiding the AI through the process. I will merge multiple Excel files, clean the data, and create an Excel report complete with a chart using Python. After that, I will build an interactive plot and even a whole dashboard. Keep in mind, I'm not writing any line of code myself throughout this process. After that, I will show you how ChatGPT can help us with SQL and Power Query. So without further ado, let us dive in. A quick disclaimer before we begin. The following examples won't focus much on analyzing the data in depth. In fact, the sample data I'm going to use is quite simple, mainly because I want to concentrate on the actual prompts instead of the data. Additionally, in my current role, I'm not heavily involved in analyzing data. Instead, I'm working on automating internal workflows using Python and VBA. With that out of the way, let us start with the first example. In my directory, I have a folder containing several Excel files. The format within each file is the same, with financial data for each date. This could represent sales reports from different branches, for example. My goal is to consolidate these files, clean up the data, analyze it, and create an Excel report with a chart. To do this, I have prepared the following Jupyter notebook. This is typically how I begin at work as well. Instead of writing all the code from start to finish, I usually test things out in a Jupyter notebook. Now, there are two approaches to generate the Excel report. You could write a very long prompt detailing your desired outcome, and in the best case scenario, you will receive a script that works right away. However, I usually prefer breaking the task down into smaller subtasks. That way, I can check the code's correctness and make adjustments along the way. Let me show you what I mean. Before providing any instructions, I like to give ChatGPT some context. For this example, I wrote, "As a data analyst, I need your help with Python. Please provide efficient, readable, and Pythonic code that follows best practices. Here is your first task in angle brackets." With that, I define the type of output I want and offer some general guidance. So let me copy this text and paste it into ChatGPT. By the way, I actually have a ChatGPT Plus subscription and have access to the GPT-4 model. However, for this tutorial, I will stick to the 3.5 version, which is free to use. With that said, let me copy and paste my first instruction. In the first step, I want to consolidate the spreadsheets. I'm telling ChatGPT to use pandas and that the Excel files are located in a folder called data. After pressing enter, I will receive the Python code along with further explanations of what the code does. So let me grab the code and paste it into my notebook. Of course, before running any code, you will want to briefly check what it does. As mentioned in the comments, the code first retrieves the list of all Excel files in the data folder. For each file, it then creates a pandas data frame, which is then appended to the combined data frame. A quick side note, with pandas version 1.4, the data frame method append has been deprecated and will be removed in future versions. Instead, you could use concat. I could point this out to ChatGPT, but for now, I will simply run the code. Alright, now we have the consolidated data here. While recording the video, I realized it might be a good idea to include the source file name in an extra column. So I turned back to ChatGPT and requested an additional source column. Just like that, ChatGPT adjusted the code. I will copy and paste it over, and when I run the code this time, we can see that we now have the information about where the data is coming from. Great, with that, let us move on to the next step. For this simple dataset, no data cleaning and preparation is required. However, I wanted to demonstrate what a prompt for such task might look like. I wrote a prompt to remove duplicates and handling missing values. I will paste this prompt into ChatGPT and press enter. Perhaps I should have been more specific in my instructions, as ChatGPT returned the entire code. I'm only interested in the data cleaning part. So I will take the additional lines, paste them into a new cell, and run it. As I mentioned, the data frame hasn't changed in my case since no data cleaning was required. Next, let's perform some basic analysis. Again, I've kept the example simple. But if you want to perform more complex calculations, that is certainly possible. You just need to be very specific with your prompt and tell ChatGPT exactly what kind of analysis you want to perform. In my simple example, I want to use the clean data and calculate the total revenue, expenses, and profit for each category. As before, I will grab my prompt and paste it into ChatGPT. I now have my updated script, and like before, I will only copy the additional lines, go back to my Jupyter notebook, and paste them into a cell. Without much effort, we calculated the revenue, expenses, and profit by category. As a final step, I would like to create an Excel report with the calculated data using the XLSX writer package. I'm mentioning which package I want to use here, but you can also try it without specifying the module. But if you already know which module to use, it is helpful to be as specific as possible in your prompts. With that in mind, let's see what ChatGPT comes up with. Alright, this output is a bit longer than the previous ones, but before running it, I need to ensure that I've also imported XLSX writer. So, back in my notebook, I will import it at the very top of our code. Next, let me grab the rest of the code and paste it below our existing code. Once again, I encourage you to take a quick look at the code before running it. I've done that already and it looks good to me. Therefore, I will just execute it. Okay, and if I return to my folder, we can see a new Excel file. Upon opening it, we have our group data and a native Excel chart. I think that's pretty cool. Without much effort, we consolidated the data and created the chart. But we can even take it a step further. Let's say instead of a standard Excel chart, ChatGPT should generate an interactive plot using Plotly and save it as an HTML file. To test the code, I will copy it and paste it into my notebook. When I execute the cell and go back to my folder, we now have a new HTML file. Here we have an interactive chart, including a title and a legend. I can hover over the bars and toggle the different KPIs on and off. But why stop here? If you want, you can even create an entire dashboard using Streamlit. The app should include a header, subheader, and the actual chart using Plotly. Just like that, ChatGPT generates the code. So, once again, I will copy it to my clipboard, create a new Python file called app.py, paste the code, and run the app by typing streamlit1 app.py. Once I press enter, the web app is served on my local host and looks like this. Now we have a simple dashboard to display the KPIs. This, of course, might be a bit overkill for such a simple analysis. But I wanted to show you what's possible with ChatGPT. For our use case, I would like to stick with our simple Excel report with a basic bar chart. However, our current code from ChatGPT isn't very clean. It works, but we didn't use any functions to separate the different steps applied to our data. This is because I told ChatGPT to do exactly that. But once we have a working script, I usually ask ChatGPT to clean it up for me. So I will copy the code to my clipboard and ask ChatGPT to make the code more Pythonic, add functions, make it more robust, and as a personal preference, use the pairflip module instead of OS. Below this prompt, I will paste the code and hit enter. As a result, we get back much cleaner code, which is easier to debug. Now all the steps are applied in separate functions, and at the very bottom, we are calling these functions. To see if it still works, I will copy the code, create a new Python file, open it up, paste my code, and execute it. Now let me return to my folder, where our Excel file has been generated again, containing the group data and the chart. So now you have the ready-to-use script to run, to consolidate and visualize your Excel data. But, of course, instead of Python, you could also use Power Query. To quickly demonstrate, I will ask ChatGPT to show me the steps to do it with Power Query. Just like that, you get a step-by-step guide on how to achieve this. And just to show you that it works, I have applied the steps. Getting the data from a folder, combining and transforming the data, adding a new custom column to calculate the profit, loading it into our worksheet, applying a pivot table on our data, and inserting a pivot chart. And the result is the same. Alright, and with that covered, let us move on to the final example I have prepared for you. This time, we will see how ChatGPT can also assist you with your SQL queries. Let's say we have the following tables: sales, customer, and products. The customer ID and product ID are foreign keys in the sales table. The data looks like this. We have our sales records, customer information in the customer table, and currently there are 5 products in our product table. Now, here's what I want ChatGPT to do. I wrote, using SQL, the task is to group the sales by products and sort by total sales amount. Since we don't need the customer table for this task, I left it out and mentioned that there are 2 tables, sales and products. Then I wrote down the column names for each table. When I hit enter, we get our SQL query. Let me copy it, create a new SQL script, and execute it. Just like that, we have now grouped the sales by product and sorted the results. Okay guys, after seeing this, let me also share some important tips. As I mentioned already, I suggest not running any code blindly. Having at least some knowledge of the respective programming language is always good. This helps you to quickly check the code provided by ChatGPT, ensuring that you don't accidentally cause any harm to your computer or data. Moreover, I wouldn't recommend sharing any sensitive information like passwords or internal company data, just to be on the safe side. Also, you might need to tweak and refine your prompts. There's a high chance that you won't get the response you're looking for on the first attempt. So you might need to reword things or be more specific about your desired output. Lastly, if you want a solution for a more extensive task, I recommend breaking it down into smaller steps and then asking ChatGPT to give you the code for each smaller step. That way, you still know what you're doing and you are not running any substantial code blindly. Later, you can piece together the different steps and refactor the code. Okay, and finally, before you go, I want to mention that I have created an add-in allowing you to integrate ChatGPT directly into your spreadsheets. So instead of copy-pasting data from your Excel workbook, you can ask your questions from Excel and receive the response directly in your workbook. If that sounds interesting to you, check out this video. You will also find the download link for the add-in in the description box below. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.